Welcome back to my channel. This is Guys My Love coming back to you again with my Daniel Fast video as promised. So for those of you who do not know what Daniel Fast is, it is a Christian based fast. It is found in the book of Daniel. The person that actually did it is Daniel. So the whole purpose of the 21 day Daniel fast is that he proved to a king that he would be stronger than the king's soldiers when he went on this 21 day fast. And at the end of those 21 days, the soldiers, they ate whatever they wanted. Saturated foods, very unhealthy foods, pretty much like what we eat today. And they were too weak to do anything, and they pretty much failed in battle. And he did this 21 day fast. So on this fast, there are certain things you can eat and certain things you can't eat. So the things you can't eat is meats, no kind of meat, no chicken, no fish, no beef, no pork, no kind of meat at all. And I love myself some hot wings, so that's hard. I'm a meat eater. No yeast, no dairy, no added sugar. You can have natural sugars that's found in fruit, but you can't have added sugar. Like, you can't take sugar and put it in some food or a drink. If it has sugar in the ingredients, that means it is added to the product. So that means you cannot eat it. And you'll be very surprised how many products have sugar in it. I didn't know that sugar was in seasoned salt until I did the Daniel fast the first time. No meat, no yeast, no dairy, no sugar, no chemicals, no preservatives. No additives, which is pretty much like added sugar. So basically, the things that you can eat on the Daniel fast is plenty of fruits, vegetables, beans, whole grain rice, like brown rice. You can't eat white rice because that is processed if it's white. The whole purpose of you fasting is to get closer to God. It's also great for weight loss as well. It's not for weight loss, but it does help. I lost 7 pounds this round on being on the Daniel fast. So if you're interested in seeing the types of things I ate on the Daniel fast and you want to get some ideas and recipes for yourself, keep watching the video. Hey you guys, it is after midnight on the 17th of February, so this actually starts day one of my fast. What I'm doing right now is I'm getting my meal for the days that I go to work, and I am going to be preparing a chickpea salad with a vinaigrette. I'm going to make this salad. I just rinsed it off and I'm going to put it together with these chickpeas. So for my vinaigrette, I'm going to make it with olive oil, apple cider vinegar, pink Himalayan, salt, turmeric. I haven't tried it with turmeric before, so I'm gonna see how I like that. Parsley flakes, black pepper, onion powder, garlic powder, and some minced onion. For my vinaigrette, I'm gonna have 1.5 cups of the vinegar that I choose. I choose to use apple cider vinegar. And for my olive oil, 1/2 cup of oil in there. You don't want an oily vinaigrette, I mean, because that makes it not a vinaigrette, right? Me and my coworkers had got a salad from some company, and supposed to be a vinaigrette that came with it, and it was more oily than anything. I couldn't even taste the vinegar. That was an oilette, not a vinaigrette. So you see why I only put 1/2 cup of oil? That's already a lot of oil. Some stuff fell on the floor and he's licking it. Excuse you. So this is my finished meal prep, my chickpea salad with my homemade vinaigrette, because most vinaigrettes in stores have sugar, added sugar to them, and sugar is not allowed on the Daniel fast. So you have to make your own at home. This is day 2 of the Daniel fast. Making me some popcorn. I'm gonna make sure it's a flat sheet of popcorn. You wanna take a boiler and pour in your own popcorn kernels. This is the Jolly Time brand, Daniel Fast Approved Oil of Choice. I'm using olive oil. And you want to cover the top of the popcorn kernels. They have to cover the top of the popcorn or it will not be enough oil to pop the popcorn. See how it just covers the top? Perfect. Now you can add your seasonings. My popcorn is popping, y'all. Here is my beautiful stovetop popcorn. And this popcorn is gonna last me for a minute. I can take this to work to eat as a salty snack. So I'll put these in lunch bag. I just wanna record what I'm feeling this day two. Yesterday on day one, it seemed like I thought about all possible food that I wanted to eat that was not Daniel Fast approved. Like, I wanted the pizza, I wanted the wings, I wanted the chocolate. I just wanna let you know that yes, you're doing this Daniel fast. Yes, you're still gonna have those cravings at times, but you can still do it. It's just a constant renewing of your mind, staying focused on God, remembering that you're doing it for God. This is about spending more time with God, getting closer with God, getting even more into His Word, creating a habit of staying more into His Word even after the fact of the Daniel fast. The Daniel fast really helps put things into perspective because you're denying yourself of eating those very delicious and unhealthy foods. So if you can have self-control over that, that shows you that you can have self-control over so many other aspects of your life. So I have made me 4 bags of popcorn out of all the popcorn that I had. And I also ate me more than a cup of some popcorn. So I decided to warm up some leftover red beans and rice that I had from yesterday. I made some red beans and rice for a burrito I had yesterday. And I just topped it off with Cajun seasoning, a little bit of pink Himalayan salt, pepper, and parsley flakes. And I might put a little hot sauce on here just to give it a little extra kick. And yep, this is my dinner. Good morning, you guys. This is day 3. This morning I'm gonna make me a natural cereal. I'm gonna be using 3 different fruits. It's gonna be strawberries, bananas, and apple. I'm gonna chop up all these fruits. I'm gonna be using unsweetened almond milk. And I'm using Quaker Oats Old Fashioned Rolled Oats. These have nothing added, it's just the oats on its own. This is my natural oatmeal cereal. I covered it in cinnamon and some more oatmeal. The oatmeal gives you that crunch that you want. Then the fruit gives you the sweetness, of course. Hey y'all, this is day 6 of the Daniel fast. And today I am making some oatmeal with rolled oats. Let me turn this eye down because I'm just trying to hurry up and cook it really fast. Unsweetened almond milk, and I put some cinnamon, ground cinnamon in it. Make sure that when you get cinnamon that it has no added sugar. Some cinnamon has added sugar, but this is just plain old cinnamon. You see that? Ingredients, cinnamon. I'm going to top this oatmeal off with some chopped up apples, blueberries, and walnuts, sliced almonds, and then I'm going to sprinkle some ground cinnamon on top. So this is my oatmeal. So this is a very filling breakfast or brunch, whatever time you want to eat it. And remember you guys, during your fast, you need to be reading your Bible more, spend more time with God. First thing when you wake up, go ahead and crack open that Bible, read your scriptures, ask God what you want to get from those scriptures. Talk with God while you're reading the Bible. Ask God for a listening heart for Him to speak to you as you read His Word. Ask Him what He wants you to hear from Him. This hours later, after I ate my oatmeal around 12 o'clock on the 6th day of the Daniel fast, I had a taste for something salty. I wanted something kind of like pickles. So on the Daniel fast, you cannot eat pickles because it has preservatives in it, and preservatives are not permitted on the Daniel fast. So what I did is I put in some distilled white vinegar, jalapeno peppers, pink Himalayan salt, and black pepper, and I just used these small cucumbers. So this is going to be my late afternoon snack. All right, y'all, this is the night of day 6 on the Daniel fast, and I made me some meatless chili.
I just looked up recipe on Pinterest and I made it from most of those ingredients. It's just a few things I forgot. I forgot to get the celery and that's it really. So this is the afternoon of day 7 of the Daniel fast. I got something from Zoe's Kitchen. I love their limeade, but I know we can drink it on the Daniel fast. It was so hard to not get it. So I had to get a hummus and salad plate, and I got some grilled potato salad. It smells really good. It is vegan. It's no mayo in here.
Alright you guys, so that is the end of this video. This is part 1 of 3, so stay tuned to watch the other parts of the Daniel fast. Let me know if you have any comments or questions about the Daniel fast. They also have a book about the Daniel fast that tells you the things that you can and cannot eat. You can also find pages of this book on Google. You just Google Daniel fast book or just Google things you can and cannot eat on the Daniel fast. And I thank you so much for watching this video. Stay tuned to watch the next 2. Thank y'all and have a blessed day. And if you're on the Daniel fast, pray. Okay? Pray and pray and pray some more. See y'all in the next video.